Ja, hallo Freunde, willkommen zurück zu Let's Play Katara Shoujo und Let's Read. Jo. Ja, wie letztes Mal hat Hisao einen Brief bekommen von seiner damaligen, ja, von seinem damaligen Schwarm, die ja so ein bisschen unnatürlich, ohne es zu wollen, dafür gesorgt hat, dass er, ja, ins Krankenhaus musste, sag ich mal. Und er hat ja keine Zeit für die Vergangenheit, sagt er. Er muss selbst lernen. Ja, wollen wir mal gucken, was er jetzt mit dem Brief noch macht oder überhaupt noch was damit macht. Und was auch mit Emi weiter hier so abgeht, sage ich mal, schauen wir mal. Now, about that homework. Ja, okay, da hätte ich natürlich auch den Cut machen können letztes Mal, okay. Egal jetzt. So, what's the plan for today anyway? I'm waiting patiently in the hallway of the girls' dormitory just outside of Amy and Rin's rooms. Amy is apparently helping Rinris getting dressed. I suppose that makes perfect sense, as I've no idea how Rin would get dressed otherwise.
Picnic.
Picnic?
That's what I said.
Sounds pretty exciting.
I know, right?
Rin chooses this moment to make an observation.
The sky seems threatening today.
Actually, I noticed that too on my way over. Despite the sunshine of the early morning, the afternoon seems to have taken a turn for the gloomy. There's a heaviness to the air, as well as that usually heralds a rainstorm. I wonder if I should have brought my umbrella. Na, man kann nie vorbereitet genug sein, ne? She's got a point. Sag mal, eigentlich, was mir gerade ein bisschen auffällt, er redet da jetzt gerade mit sich selber, mit den Mädels redet er, aber die sind doch gar nicht mit ihm zusammen hier draußen. Bisschen merkwürdig gerade, ne? Irgendwie. Amy, you're sure that you still want to risk getting caught in the rain? I don't even know why I bothered asking. Amy pops out of Rin's room into the hallway looking shocked that I'd even suggest canceling our plans.
Of course. What's the threat of rain supposed to stop me?
I can't help but grin at her belligerent response. It's almost like she's daring the rain to come. If Mother Nature were walking down the street, I think Amy would probably start a fight with her. Or at the least challenge her to a race. In fact, Amy seems almost aggressively cheerful today. Rin wanders out into the hallway looking her usual self. Well then, are we all ready to go? Ja, Picknick mit den beiden Mädels, warum denn nicht, ne? Wird bestimmt ganz nett.
I'm ready.
Rin nods and says a single word.
Basket.
Beg pardon?
The basket in Amy's room. You should carry it.
Wozu brauchen wir einen Korb? Amy claps a hand to her mouth, embarrassed.
Oh my gosh, I almost forgot to all about it. Nice save, Rin.
Amy darts into her room and emerges with what looks like a very well-stocked picnic basket. Ach so, ja klar. As she hands it over to me, I note that it feels heavy enough to be one too. Good Lord, how much food did she pack? More to the point, where'd she get the money for all of this? So, are we set to head out?
Yep.
Rin gives another nod and we head out of the dormitory. I can't help but frown when I notice how gray the sky's gotten in the 10 minutes I was inside. Das kann ja was werden. Still, Amy does not seem concerned by such pretty concerns as the color of the sky. She's positively skipping as we walk. Which reminds me, where are we going? This brings Amy up short and she shoots me an embarrassed look.
You know, I hadn't really thought of that. What do you think, Hizo? Well, there's a spot where we ate during the festival, but it might be nice to leave the campus for a while. However, I'm not sure if there's any good places to do that in town.
Ja, kennt sich ja auch noch nicht so aus, ne?
Just as I'm about to open my mouth, Rin unexpectedly interjects with a suggestion.
There's a park in town near the art shop.
Okay.
Great idea, Rin. I totally forgot all about the place.
Crisis averted. Do you know how to get there, Rin?
Rin shrugs.
It's pretty likely.
Good enough for me.
I would prefer knowing for sure, but what the hell. Lead on, Rin. The three of us quickly make our way off campus and take the road down into town.
This basket's a bit heavy. I hope that the park is close by.
We pass the art supply store, Rin slowing her pace slightly as we go by. Amy notices Rin's change of pace and stops.
You wanna go in, Rin?
Rin shrugs.
Nothing I need.
Are you sure?
There's the slightest flutter of a smile on Rin's face, quickly replaced with her usual expression.
Life's uncertain, but on this at least I'm pretty sure. Nice of you to offer.
Well, it's not like I'm the one carrying the basket. But I bet Hisao wouldn't have minded anyway, right?
Oh, of course not. This is hardly a heavy load. I flex for emphasis.
Amy stifles a snort of laughter by pointing to the park at which we've suddenly arrived.
Oh, I remember this place. I ran into you here that one time, didn't I, Rin?
Rin's eyebrow raises slightly.
Maybe. I'm unwilling to say for certain, one way or the other. Memory's a tricky thing, you know.
Well, I'll be. We made it in one piece after all. The sun's still nowhere to be seen, but neither Amy nor Rin seem to mind. We find a spot to sit on the grass, and I set the basket down gratefully.
Schönes Bild, ja?
There's a surprising amount of food prepared. Maybe we were supposed to be joined by some of Amy's teammates or something.
Ich glaube, die hat eher mit deinem Appetit gerechnet.
I'm starving, dig in.
Oder mit ihrem eigenen. Mal schauen.
She attacks the food as if she had nothing to eat for years. I'm just reaching for the food myself when I feel the first drop of rain land on the back of my hand.
Auweia.
Oh. Looks like the weather's not going to cooperate with us after all.
Amy glares at the sky as if that alone will hold back the rain.
Ja, jetzt haben wir... Ja, jetzt ist der Regen...
Ich weiß gar nicht, was ich gerade sagen wollte. Egal.
I very nearly believe she can do it. It's one heck of a glare.
Ja. Das wird nicht reichen, um den Regen zu stoppen.
It had better cooperate. You hear me, Sky? You stop that raining right this instant.
The sky doesn't seem inclined to listen to her, despite the commanding tone she's taken with it. Instead, the rain seems to increase. Rin wrinkles her nose in distaste at this turn of events.
Regrettable. What do you mean?
Rin shrugs.
I could paint this if I weren't out here. Shame to miss it, it's all.
She doesn't seem angry or annoyed about it, just a little disappointed.
Amy laughs in response to Rin's comment.
Guess we should have stopped in that art supply store after all, huh?
The rain increases a little more, offended that we haven't fled yet.
Er will uns wirklich vertreiben, der Regen. Also ich würde ja die Beine in die Hand nehmen. Despite the warm temperatures, we've been enjoying. The rain is rather cold. I wish I brought my umbrella. Hey, we should probably head inside to keep dry.
We are already pretty wet, Hizo.
Yeah, but we can dry off this way and maybe wait out the storm. You don't want to catch a cold or anything, do you? Emi considers this for a moment. I can tell that part of her wants to stay out in the rain, just to spite the weather. Unfortunately for her, the weather hardly cares about what we do.
I suppose you're right. Where could we go?
I don't have an answer for her. The area is still pretty new to me. Though I guess I'm slowly getting used to the school itself, the surrounding town remains a mystery. All I know is the art supply store, and that's only because we've just passed it. Fortunately, Amy soon snaps her fingers in triumph.
That's it! There's a tea shop nearby! We could have some tea and dry out, no problem.
That doesn't sound like a bad idea. Great, you know where it is? Amy nods, looking fairly confident.
Sure do, I think. But it'll be an adventure either way, right?
Adventure, huh? Well, I suppose we could use a little adventure. I think as long as we get out of the rain, I'll be happy. The picnic basket is a little lighter now, at least. Lead on! Rin and I follow Amy as she weaves through the streets with something approaching confidence.
Now a left here. There, the Shanghai!
Amy beams triumphantly as she points to the tea shop. It seems fairly crowded inside, a symptom of the sudden rain, I'm sure.
Welcome, can I...
I'm surprised to find out that our waitress is none other than Yuko. She sure looks the part in her uniform. It's hard to believe this is the same librarian from our school. Does she work two jobs? I guess that must be it.
Oh, it's you.
Yuko seems to know Amy. Amy grins brightly, pleased to be remembered.
Hey, Yuko!
Hi, Yuko. I didn't know you worked here too.
Do I know you? You seem awfully familiar, but I don't think I've ever seen you in here.
We met at your other job at the Yamako Library, remember? Her eyes widen in memory.
Yeah, that's it. Nice to see you again. Oh no, this is bad. I should have remembered a customer's face. I'm sorry. I'm terribly sorry.
Yuko goes from realization to panic in a split second, performing a series of high-speed bows. I narrowly avoid getting head-butted in the process. Whoa, hey, calm down. Listen, I wasn't the customer when we first met. In fact, I hadn't ever been to the Shanghai, so it's all right. Not the best display of logic, but it seems to relax her a little.
Do you really think so?
Yeah, I'm sure. Positive. Isn't that right, girls? Amy has been watching this little drama unfold with considerable bemusement.
Yep, it sure is. Well, okay. So Yuko got room to seat us?
Yuko nods and leads us to a corner booth, providing us with some small towels before taking our order.
What will you have? Cake and some tea too, I guess.
Ja, Kuchen und Tee ist immer gut.
What kind of cake? Surprise me.
Yuko looks uncomfortable at the thought of surprising anyone, but she gives a nod and turns to Rin.
And for you? I take a straw. My feet are all wet.
Sorry?
The drinking kind of straw. One, please.
Yuko is obviously uncertain of what to think about this. She fiddles with her pen and stationery for a moment, looking like she's about to cry before turning in my direction.
And you, sir?
Just tea, I think. Amy would probably yell at me if I ordered cake.
Ah, come on, Hiso. Don't let me be the only one with food. I feel like a pig.
Just trying to eat healthy. Your orders, after all.
Well, today's your day off. You can be healthy tomorrow.
Well then, I suppose I will have some cake after all. Yuko seems slightly irritated that I'm changing my mind.
What kind?
I glance at Amy and grin.
Surprise me!
Okay, das ist jetzt wirklich nicht schlecht. Yuko sighs and nods.
Very well, your order will be out soon.
Despite the crowd, our order does indeed arrive quickly.
Thanks, Yuko.
Yuko nods in appreciation.
This is a different guy than usual, isn't it?
What? Different guy?
Amy must notice my confusion because she seems a little embarrassed.
What? Oh yeah, I guess he is. This is my friend Hiso.
We've met.
Huh?
Small world.
Okay, wen meint sie jetzt mit einem anderen Typ? Das ist jetzt eine Frage, ne? Vielleicht kriegen wir das ja noch raus.
Well, let me know if you need anything.
With that, Yuko takes off like a shot to wait on some other tables, leaving me to ponder her comment.
Different guy, huh? I guess it makes sense, right? Amy's pretty popular, or so I've been told.
It's probably that kid from the track team.
This is stupid. I can just ask Amy.
So, who's... Oh God. Sorry, Leute. So, who's...
Kann ich das nicht aussprechen?
So, who's this other guy, huh? Okay. You got a secret lover or something?
Amy laughs again, only I get the feeling it's from nervousness as much as anything else.
It's just the track team captain. He likes coming down here after practice sometimes. So if we have anything to discuss, I tag along.
Sounds mighty suspicious to me.
Oh, sind die gleich eifersüchtig hier, oder was?
Oh, I see. I could let the matter drop, but I can't resist at least getting another dig in.
So it is a secret lover.
I knew it. Rin watches our play, seeming mildly amused, before muttering something that I don't quite catch.
Anyway. What?
Huh?
Rin jerks back from whatever her mind wandered off to.
Huh? What did you just say?
Huh?
No, before that.
No idea.
Oh well. Okay.
I let the matter drop, but I can't help notice that Amy seems relieved. Relieved that Rin interrupted the conversation.
Maybe I went a little too far. Conversation dies down for a moment as Amy and I busy ourselves with cake. Mine is strawberry and surprisingly good.
Amy seems to think so too as she suddenly reaches over with her fork and steals a bit.
Thief!
Pirate, there's a difference.
We are not on water.
Well, no, but there's a lot of water outside, so it still works, right? Besides, you can have some of mine. I think it's cranberry or something. I should have asked for the strawberry. I like strawberries.
Feel free to help yourself to mine if you really must.
For some reason, I feel compelled to add.
Seeing as how you've already done it once and all.
Amy sticks her tongue out at me, but that doesn't stop her from appropriating my cake. I try some of hers as well. It's raspberry and pretty good.
Ja, so, ne? Die Kuchenstähler, das kennen wir auch. Immer vom anderen probieren, ne? Das muss manchmal sein. Da kann man manchmal nichts machen. Ist ja auch immer verlockend, ne? Weil Kuchen vom anderen ist immer verlockend. Meistens, also, ich kenne das selber. Meistens ist das andere mal das, was man dann doch eher gewollt hätte, als das, was man bestellt hat. Naja.
The rain's let up.
It would appear that Rin is correct. Good timing, too. I finished my food and it looks like Amy has as well.
Well, we'd better pay and get a move on before it starts raining again. It takes a few minutes to get Yuko's attention, but we pay and get out pretty quickly.
So, do you want to return to the park?
My jaw nearly drops. Are you kidding? It's probably going to rain again. In fact, I think I just felt some raindrops.
You may be right. Well, okay, I'll let you off the hook this time, but you owe me a picnic now, got it?
I don't know if she's addressing me, Rin, or the both of us.
Fine. Now hurry up, I wanted to get some laps in at the track, and it would be nice to do it without the rain.
I thought this was your day off.
Well...
Amy suddenly seems reluctant to explain herself.
I need the practice, and I need to burn off that cake anyway.
Why do I get the feeling that she's leaving something out? Are you sure it wasn't that much cake?
No, it wasn't that much cake for you. I ate most of it.
She's got a point there. Still, I feel like I should at least offer to run with her. Ja, Freunde, wir sind bei der ersten Entscheidung angekommen. Im zweiten Kapitel. Was sollen wir jetzt tun? Sollen wir jetzt nichts weiter dazu sagen oder sollen wir anbeten? Sollen wir ihr anbieten, gemeinsam mit uns zu laufen? Sie will ja offensichtlich doch aus welchen Gründen auch immer unbedingt nochmal laufen gehen. Die Gründe, ja, ich glaube, die sind vielleicht ein bisschen vorgeschoben, was er da gesagt hat. Ich weiß es jetzt aber auch nicht mehr genau. Auf jeden Fall, ja, sollen wir ihr anbieten, mitzukommen oder sollen wir es nicht tun? Boah, ganz einfache Frage. Der Part ist an dieser Stelle auch, ja, schon recht weit fortgeschritten. Deswegen beende ich den an dieser Stelle. Und, ja, lasse euch wieder die Entscheidung, wie ich es meistens tue. Und dann sehen wir ja, wie es weitergeht. Also, mit Amy rennen, laufen oder nicht? Ganz einfache Kiste, ganz einfache Frage. Ja, bin auf eure Entscheidung gespannt. Wir hören uns dann beim nächsten Mal wieder, wenn es wieder heißt Let's Play, Let's Read Katawa Shoujo. Bis dahin, macht's gut, ciao, euer Dreambird.